Welcome to our Proactive Studios. I'm Natalie Stoberman, joined by the CEO and Chairman at Fernhill Corp, Chris Kern. And Chris, how are you doing today?
Great, thanks, Natalie.
Fabulous. Now let's introduce you to our investor community. How does Fernhill specialize in Web3 enterprise infrastructure building when it comes to digital asset trading and NFTs?
So we actually made an acquisition about a year and a half ago of MainBloq, and they have a digital asset trading platform that connects multiple exchanges into one common place and also provides a suite of trading tools to help traders make better trading decisions. That platform is also available on a white label basis, and we're also configuring it where it can be on-premise if need be. And then on the NFT side, we actually built a ground-up platform called DigX that focuses on tokenization and a marketplace for NFTs. I think, you know, going forward, one of the big areas for NFTs is really tokenization of alternative assets that are, you know, an investment vehicle for people to look and hold investments on a long term versus where NFTs typically opened up at as artwork and collectibles. Bigger picture, longer term is on the alt asset space.
Right. Yes, it's definitely worth mentioning that NFTs are not just about art. And I'm sure people are wondering, like, NFTs have taken a huge hit from when they were so popular just a few summers ago. Why would the company still continue to be bullish on NFTs just based on the fact that there are a variety of different uses and it's growing every day?
Well, like I mentioned, you know, the alternative asset space is just literally, it's a $1 trillion industry. And it hasn't really been digitized much at all to this current point. And we think the technology is there. The market is certainly improving. And we believe there's just a big future for assets, investments, and things of that nature to be tokenized and put on a blockchain. And we just think right now is really the big part of that curve coming to shape right now. And we just want to make sure we have some infrastructure available. Again, we'll also make that available on a white label basis for people who want to have a brand friendly platform and presence in the space, as well as, you know, customize tokenization capabilities that you know, most other companies can't offer.
So, Chris, how does Fernhill intend to ride this wave on the expectations that NFTs and other tokenization will continue to grow in the coming years?
Well, we didn't think there's going to be an overall adoption amongst institutions at a much higher level. The big, I'll say, blocking issue on that is the regulatory environment and the current framework that's in place, or lack of a framework for that matter. We think that's going to be coming around real soon here, given the voices out there pushing for a real kind of crypto digital asset regime to be in place. Whether that's a function of the CFTC or the SEC or a combo of both. And we think that's really starting to come around now. We hear, you know, Congress pushing for it. We hear from all types of leaders pushing for it. You have, you know, corporate America in the digital asset world that is really pushing for it. And so I think it's really just a matter of time. It's not a matter of if. And once that framework is in place, we'll see a huge, you know, incoming flux of institutional investors and large corporations coming into the space very quickly. And we think that's going to be the big upswing in the industry overall. And we think that's literally, you know, 6 to 12 months out when that's going to start.
Wow, that's quite the timeline. But Chris, thank you so much for sharing Fernhill with us, and we wish you the best of luck.
Great. Thank you very much.
Again, the chairman and CEO at Fernhill Corp, Chris Kern.